The COVID-19 strain that originated from the Philippines no longer a variant of interest. According to the Philippine Health Department, the World Health Organization now considers P3 as a variant under alert for further monitoring. The WHO has said variants of interest can be reclassified if they conclusively demonstrate that they no longer pose a major added risk compared to other circulating variants. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte, meanwhile, expresses concerns as more variants emerge across the world.
Health authorities around the world would have noted that the global pandemic recovery is at risk with the rise of new COVID-19 variants. The emergence of the new COVID-19 variants like Delta and Lambda are truly a cause of concern, and the government closely monitoring our borders across these strains to prevent local transmission. Having said that, our best defense is still to be vaccinated as soon as possible.
COVID-19 cases increase again in 8 Metro Manila cities. The health department says 7 of those posted a positive 2-week case growth rate. These are Makati, San Juan, Muntinlupa, Manila, Mandaluyong, Malabon, and Navotas. Among those cities, Makati and San Juan are considered high risk due to their health care utilization rates. The health department also notes Las Piñas City showed an increasing trend over the past 2 weeks as well.
Metro Manila is not yet ready to shift to modified general community quarantine. Professor Ranjit Rai of the Octor Research Group says, while the COVID-19 situation in NCR is generally improving, government must sustain the gains first before easing protocols further. Metro Manila is under GCQ with some restrictions until July 15th.
Sa NCR, I think we should continue with the GCQ. Pwede tayo magluwag dun sa mga business establishments. Kaya ako sinasabi to, may banta tayo ng Delta. Mm-hmm. Meron rin tayong, although maganda ang sitwasyon ngayon sa NCR, kailangan ho tuloy-tuloy masustain natin to habang sinasabayan natin ang pag-increase ng vaccination natin. Mm-hmm. So para sa akin ha, mukhang we are not yet ready for MGCQ. That's definite na yon. Mm-hmm. We do not qualify even based on government's criteria for MGCQ. We won't qualify pa as of now.
Rai adds he is not in favor of the health department's plan to deploy Johnson & Johnson vaccines to all regions in the Philippines.
Meron na tayong blueprint yung NCR plus 8. Sana ho hindi mabahira ng politika ng mga iba-ibang influences yung ating plan. If we stick to that plan, the country will move forward. Mm-hmm. Yun po ang aming tingin. Now, yung ibang vaccines na madadagdagan sa portfolio, siyempre J&J ho, ang laking bagay niya kasi isang dose lang yan. Ang fear namin, baka nawawala ang focus dito sa NCR plus 8. Mm-hmm. Ang NCR plus 8, pag ginawa ng gobyerno niya, hindi niya lang tinutulungan ng NCR plus 8, tinutulungan niya yung buong bansa kasi babagsak ang COVID cases dun sa lugar na yon. Mabubuksan ang ekonomiya sa mga lugar na yon, at yung effect ng dalawang bagay na to will have impact all over the country kasi ang pagkalat ho ng COVID gagaling ho dito sa NCR plus.
The Philippines formally enters an agreement to participate in the World Health Organization's vaccine solidarity trial. The Department of Science and Technology says Health Secretary Francisco Duque III and WHO's chief scientist have already signed the letter of agreement. It adds the Philippines has received the WHO's final clinical trial protocol and standard operating procedures. 4 vaccine brands will be rolled out in the trial. But the DOSC cannot disclose the brands yet, pending the approval of the Food and Drug Administration.
Makakadiskubre tayo ng pinaka-epektibong COVID-19 vaccines na naaayon sa pangangailangan ng Filipino population na may epektibong bilang ng doses, may nilalaang pinakabang panahon ng proteksyon, at madaling i-administer at i-manufacture sa ating bansa.
The COVAX program plans to purchase up to 550 million doses of Chinese COVID-19 vaccines by the first half of 2022. Gavi, the co-lead of the program, says it signed advanced purchase agreements with two Chinese pharmaceutical companies, Sinopharm and Sinovac. Under the deal, the companies will provide 110 million doses by the end of October.
And these doses are, you know, very much needed now for many countries that are waiting for vaccines. That showed that the Sinovac was about 87% effective against hospitalization, 90% against severe disease, and 86.3% against deaths. So it shows very high efficacy.
Canada will donate millions more COVID-19 vaccine doses to the COVAX facility. Ottawa says it will give 17.7 million AstraZeneca jabs. That's on top of 13 million doses it earlier pledged to donate to COVAX during a G7 summit. Meanwhile, Japan says 11 million doses it donated through COVAX will be sent this month to various countries, including Bangladesh, Cambodia, and Pacific Island states. Tokyo has also announced it will ship out 1 million more jabs each to Indonesia, Taiwan, and Vietnam this week as part of bilateral deals with those countries.
The Philippine Food and Drug Administration, studying the link of Johnson & Johnson's COVID-19 vaccine to a rare neurological disease following a warning from U.S. regulators. We now have Kat Domingo on the line for the details. Kat?
Hi, Denise. The Philippine Food and Drug Administration has advised those who have been jabbed with Johnson & Johnson's Janssen vaccine to closely monitor symptoms post-inoculation after the agency's U.S. counterpart said that J&J's COVID-19 jab may result in increased risk of the Guillain-Barré syndrome. The Guillain-Barré syndrome is a rare disorder wherein the immune system attacks nerves and may affect the body's neurological system. Philippine FDA Director General Eric Domingo says the association between the disease and Janssen vaccines is still being investigated. Now, in a separate statement, the Department of Health says the risk remains very low and that current data shows that the benefits of getting the vaccine continues to outweigh any reported reactions to these jabs. The DOH urged both patients and doctors to immediately report all suspected reactions to COVID-19 vaccines so that the agency's epidemiology and surveillance units could immediately assess these for causality. The Philippines approved the emergency use of J&J's COVID-19 vaccines in April, and the World Health Organization says the country is expected to receive some 3 million Janssen doses from the COVAX facility by this month.
Thank you, Kat. The World Health Organization warns about the dangers of mixing and matching COVID-19 vaccines of different brands. We have this report.
People who are thinking about mixing and matching.
The World Health Organization's chief scientist on Monday advised against people mixing and matching COVID-19 vaccines from different manufacturers, calling it a dangerous trend since there is very little information on doing so.
So it's a little bit of a dangerous trend here where people are in a data-free, evidence-free zone as far as a mix and match. There is limited data on mix and match. It will be a chaotic situation in countries if citizens start, you know, deciding when and who they should be taking a second or a third or a fourth dose.
Dr. Soumya Swaminathan made her comments during the WHO's latest online briefing. Infectious disease experts are weighing whether people who received Johnson & Johnson's single-dose vaccine should receive a booster of the Pfizer or Moderna mRNA-based vaccine, which are said to be more effective against the highly contagious Delta variant. One of those who did mix and match is Dr. Angela Rasmussen, a researcher at the University of Saskatchewan's Vaccine and Infectious Disease Organization, who made headlines after she said on Twitter that she had gotten a dose of Pfizer's vaccine in June after receiving J&J's in April. She also advised other J&J recipients, especially those living in areas with low vaccination rates, to talk to their doctors about doing the same. Separately, Pfizer is pushing U.S. and European regulators to authorize a third booster shot to supplement its two-dose regimen. But health officials, including the WHO's Swaminathan, have said there is no medical evidence that a third Pfizer shot is necessary.
It has to be based on the science and the data, not on individual companies.
Instead of offering booster shots to highly vaccinated, wealthy nations, the WHO's director general on Monday said companies like Pfizer should send those vaccines to the WHO to give to poorer countries whose unvaccinated citizens desperately need them against a Delta variant he described as, quote, ripping around the world at a scorching pace.